بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم السلام عليكم Welcome to Organic Chemistry class. Today our topic is the concept of hybridization. We started from the general overview of Organic Chemistry course in lecture 1. The second lecture was about definition, history, sources, application of organic compounds, then characteristic properties of organic compounds, then purification and characterization of organic compounds and how to present organic compounds, and finally classification and functional group introduction. In lecture 3 we discussed about the chemical bonding in organic compounds, types of chemical bonding and characteristics of chemical bonding. In this lecture we shall cover the following 3 topics. Number first, the concept of hybridization, that what is hybridization, the definition, the background. Next, what are different types of hybridization? Example of sp3, sp2 and sp hybridization. And the last section is comparison of these different types. Comparison of sp3 with sp2 and sp. And we shall compare these 3 types in terms of geometry, bond angle and other some characteristic properties, that how the stability, the bond strength are different among these 3 types of hybridizations. So let we start from the basic introduction of hybridization. As you know, the electronic configuration of carbon is a member of group 4 elements and it has 6 electrons. Its electronic configuration is 1s2, 2s2, 2p2. If we present the valence electron, so carbon's valence electron can be presented as 2s2, then 2p2 can be presented as 2px1, 2py1. While the third box is empty because we have no electron, we have only 4 valence electrons of carbon atom. So this is the electronic configuration of carbon. 1s2, 2s2, 2p2. We can present in boxes like this. 1s2, 2s2, then 2p2. As you know about the quantum numbers and you know the rules for electronic configuration, so no need to explain that here because you have already studied that in your first year FSC course, first year and then also in second year. Now we don't have concern about this 1s2 electrons because this 1s2 is first shell. We can say that this 1s2 is not involved in bonding, in chemical bonding. While 2s in 2p is second or valence, we can say the last shell. So our concern is about 2s in 2p. That's why if we present the valence electron, we can present it like this. 2s2, 2px1, 2py1, 2pz is empty. And as you know, s is spherical shape, p is dumbbell shape. This is x-axis, y-axis and z-axis. Okay. Now, according to valence bond theory, the number of covalent bonds formed by an atom is equal to the number of unpaired electrons present in it. Now, if we look at the electronic configuration, how many unpaired electrons are there? There are only 2 unpaired electrons present. There are only 2 unpaired electrons present in the valence shell. That's why carbon is supposed to be divalent. Divalent means carbon is supposed to form only 2 bonds with other atoms. But practically, we see the simplest example is methane. Carbon is attached to 4 different hydrogen atoms. And this ability to form four bonds is called tetravalent nature of carbon, tetravalency. Now this is the first question, first puzzle, that if carbon has only two unpaired electrons, then why carbon is forming four bonds? I'm stressing again that if carbon has only two unpaired electrons, then why carbon is tetravalent? Why carbon is forming four different bonds? This is the first question. Second, if we look at the electronic configuration, the valence electron, there are two suborbital, S and P. And we know that S and P orbitals have different shape and energy. The shape is presented here. Different shape, S spherical shape, dumbbell shape. Also, S orbital is closer to nucleus as compared to P orbital. So energy level is also different. The energy level is also different. We can say that P orbital has higher energy state as compared to S orbital. Or we can say that S orbital is closer to nucleus as compared to P orbital. It means that when the shape of S and P orbitals are different, then why the four bonds which are formed by carbon atoms in methane, all the four bonds are identical. All the four bonds in methane are identical. It means that they have same length and they have same dissociation energy, same energy status. It's supposed to be the bond formed by S orbital should be different from the bond formed by P orbital, because the energy level of S is different from the energy level of P. Similarly, the length should be different for S and for P, because S is closer to nucleus. And that's why these electrons are more tightly held by the nucleus as compared to P orbital. This is the second question. In summary, we can say that carbon is not divalent. And also the bonds formed by carbon are identical. Why? Why carbon form four bonds? How? And why all the four bonds are identical? What is the reason? Now here is a concept of hybridization. Hybridization is a theory that is used to explain certain molecular geometries that would have not been possible otherwise. So on the basis of hybridization, we can answer these two questions. We can justify the tetravalency of carbon. We can justify the identical bond nature of methane and also other molecules. So let me define the hybridization. It is a process of mixing up pure orbitals to give set of new equivalent orbital. How? We can simply define it as, what is hybridization? Hybridization is mixing of orbitals. What kind of orbitals? Hybridization of different pure orbitals of different shape and of different energy. And what will be the outcome? To give new equivalent orbitals which are identical, which have same shape, which have same energy, but equivalent in number. For example, if 1 is combined with 1p, so it means the two orbitals combined, the net result will be two hybridized orbital. But the difference between the unhybridized and hybridized orbital before hybridization and after hybridization is the energy status and the shape before hybridization were different, but after hybridization both will have similar shape and same energy status. So the mixing of orbital is called hybridization. Mixing up different orbitals, mixing of orbitals of different shape and different energy. And after mixing, it will give identical orbitals. Identical orbital means same shape, same energy. Remember that the total energy of a hybridized system, it means that the total energy after hybridization is lower than the energy of the original one. That is, the hybridized orbital has lower energy than before hybridization. So the total energy of a hybridized system is lower than the energy of the original one, since the orbital adjusts themselves. That's why the orbital will try to adjust themselves in a more stable configuration, where they are isoenergetic. They have same amount of energy. Their energy status now will be similar. And this is due to hybridization. We can explain the tetravalent nature of carbon. We can justify the identical bond length and strength of a molecule. That why carbon form identical bonds, why the four bonds formed by carbon are identical. Now look at the electronic configuration of carbon, and then look at the status of carbon before hybridization and after hybridization. We can say that before hybridization, we can call it ground state. That is the original state of a carbon atom. When electrons are excited, energy is provided, what happened? The electron get hybridized. So we have three states: ground state, excited state, and hybridized state. We have to differentiate among these three. What is mean by ground state? What is excited state? And what is hybridized state? Look at this. 1s2, 2s2, 2p2. We can present in boxes. 1s2, 2s2, 2p2. This is ground state. Okay, ground state. It is presented here also. 1s2, 2s2, 2p2. If one electron from 2s is promoted to this mtp, now it is called excited state. What is the difference between ground and excited state? You see, ground state and excited state is similar for 1s2. But look at here, 2s2 here, when one electron is promoted, now it becomes 2s1. And here, p1, px1, py1, pz1. So this is the main difference between ground state and excited state. The third one is hybridization. What happened during hybridization? Hybridization is mixing up orbitals. Now look at this. If one electron of the S shell, this is S shell, combined with one electron of the higher energy state, that is P state, it means that one is combined with 1p. Look at the red. One is combined with 1p. What will be the result? The result will be sp hybridization. If one is combined, look at blue color part. If one is combined with 2p, it will be sp2 hybridization. Sp, 1s, 1p. sp2, 1s combined with 2p. Now look at this green. Look at this green part. When 1 is combined with 3p, it is called sp3 hybridization. So we have three types of hybridization: sp, sp2, and sp3. What is the difference between among these three? Number first, the ground state for all these, look at this, 1s2, excited state 1s2, hybridization 1s2. Then the ground state 2s2, excited state 2s1, And after hybridization, this is 2s1 will either combine with 1p, so it will be sp, or this 2s1 will combine with 2p, so it is sp2 hybridization, or it will combine with 3p, so it will be sp3 hybridization. It means that the amount of s, the character of s, here is 50%, here is 33.3%, and here is 25%, because here 1s1p, 1:1, in sp2, 1:2, in sp3, 1:3. Now the next topic is types of hybridization. We have already discussed this, the electronic configuration of carbon, 1s2, 2s2, 2px, 2py, 2pz ground state. Then 1s2, 2s1, because one electron is promoted here. When this 2s1 combined with 3, it is called sp3. When after excitation, it combines with 2p and 1p remains unhybridized, 1p remains unchanged, it is called sp2. When 2 is combined with 1p and 2p's remain unhybridized, it is called sp. Now compare. In sp3 hybridization, there is no unhybridized orbital. All the phi orbitals are participating. In sp2 hybridization, 1p remains unhybridized. So now we have 3 hybridized orbital and 1 unhybridized orbital. In sp, only 1 is combined with 1p. The remaining 2p remain unhybridized. So now we have 2 hybridized orbital and 2 unhybridized orbital. I am repeating, in sp3, 4 hybridized orbital, because 1 plus 3 is equal to 4. So sp3, 1s3p. So 1 plus 3 is equal to 4. So we have 4 hybridized orbital. sp2, 1s2p. 1 plus 2 is equal to 3. So we have 3 hybridized orbital, while 1 unhybridized orbital. In sp, 1 plus 1 is equal to 2. So we have 2 hybridized orbital and 2 unhybridized orbital. Look at sp3 hybridization. This is how it looks. S3p's, 1 is combined with 3p's, because one electron is already promoted to p, so it is actually excited state. So what happens? The shape of orbitals change, the energy status change. Now s orbital has spherical shape, p orbital has dumbbell shape, but the hybridized orbital will be shaped like this. When 1 is combined with 3p's, it results 4sp3 hybridized orbital. The shape and energy of hybridized orbital will be totally different from the shape and energy of unhybridized orbital. So now these 4 orbitals are identical. These 4 orbitals have same energy. These 4 orbitals have same shape. The contribution of s is 25%, while the contribution of 5 is 75%. But the overall shape and energy of all these 4 are similar. Again, this is orbital presentation of sp3 hybridization. 1 2s orbital combined with 3 2p orbital, it result 4 sp3 hybridized orbital. If we look at the geometry, so 4 sp3 Hybridized orbital are present on, and the bond angle between these is 109.5 degree. These are at maximum distance from each other. And methane is an example of sp3 hybridization, where four hydrogen atoms are attached to carbon. The overlapping is ssp3 overlapping, because hydrogen has one electron in s orbital, so four hydrogen are there, and there will be ssp3 overlapping of orbital that will result four bonds, four covalent bonds. The second type is sp2 hybridization. Now I think it is clear to you. Here you can see that 2s1, again it is excited state. Keep in mind it is excited state. So 2s1, 2p3, when one electron 2s1 combined with only 2p's, this one remain unchanged. What will be the result after hybridization? We have three hybridized orbital sp2 and one unhybridized orbital. Look at the shape. When these orbitals combine, it result different shape. The unhybridized orbital will have different shape. So in sp2 hybridization, one is combined with 2p's, while 1p remains unhybridized. Now the energy status of this and the shape of this will be different from the remaining three orbitals. Ethene is an example of sp2 hybridization. Now look at this. This carbon has three hybridized orbital. sp2 first one, sp2 second, sp2 third. And it has one unhybridized p orbital. So in ethene, each carbon has three sp2 orbital and one p orbital. Similarly, this will also sp2 hybridized carbon. Now how the bond is formed between these two carbon? First of all, this is sp2, this is sp2, and they approach to each other. It is head-to-head overlap, end-to-end overlap, face-to-face overlap. So sigma bond is formed. The remaining two sp2 combines with two hydrogen, and as a result sp2 s overlap, sp2 s overlap. Now what about the unhybridized p orbital? The unhybridized p orbital, which has two lobes above and below the plane, how they overlap? It is sidewise overlap of one p with another p. We can say that unhybridized p orbital of this carbon overlap with unhybridized orbital of this carbon, and as a result a pi bond is formed. This pi bond is more exposed than the sigma bond. A pi bond is usually formed after the formation of sigma bond, and we have already discussed the difference between sigma and pi bond in our previous lecture. The third type is sp hybridization. You see here one electron of 2s combined with one electron of 2p. So now we would have two hybridized orbital, sp hybridized orbital. The remaining two p's remain unchanged and they are unhybridized. So in sp hybridization, we have two sp orbital, sp hybridized orbital, and two unhybridized p orbitals. Two sp hybridized orbital and two unhybridized p orbitals. The energy and the shape of these two orbitals are different from the unhybridized orbital. Hybridized orbital has lower energy as compared to unhybridized orbital. Acetylene ethane is an example of sp hybridization. You see, this carbon atom is sp hybridized. Sp hybridization, this system has two unhybridized p. There will be two overlapping, sidewise overlapping, two sidewise overlapping. Look at the overlapping, how all these four bonds are formed. Sp-sp overlap between carbon two carbon atoms, head-to-head overlap, result into a sigma bond. Similarly, sp and s overlap, carbon-hydrogen bond, sp and s overlap, carbon-hydrogen bond. So, two sigma bonds are formed, one sigma bond between carbon and hydrogen, and one sigma bond between carbon and carbon. And carbon is tetravalent. Now the remaining two bonds are formed by the contribution of two unhybridized p orbitals. So the two unhybridized p orbital, this is one unhybridized p orbital, this one. One is presented by blue color and the other one is presented by gray color. So the two unhybridized p orbitals form two pi bonds. So ethane has sigma bond, pi bond. Three, the fourth one with hydrogen. This is how ethane is formed. Look at methane, ethene and ethane. In methane, sp3 hybridization. In ethane, sp2. And in ethane sp hybridization. Again, look at this. In methane, no unhybridized p orbital. In case of ethene, one unhybridized p orbital. Well, here, two unhybridized p orbital, this one and this one. The next topic is comparison of sp3, sp2, sp hybridization. How sp3, sp2 and sp system are different from each other? You have to compare the geometry, bond angle, also in term of number of unhybridized orbitals, s character in each, electronegativity, which one is more electronegative. We can also say that out of these three hybridized orbital, sp, sp2 and sp3, where the electron will be tightly held or where electron will be closely to the nucleus. So electronegativity, difference among sp3, sp2 and sp. Next, order of stability, which one is more stable, bond length of sp3, sp2 and sp, and the last one is SH strength. Now, all the comparison is given here. You have to understand this one. You have to look at the differences. First of all, I will start from the geometry. So, sp3 hybridization, it has tetrahedral geometry. SP2 has trigonal planar, while SP geometry is linear. Here the bond angle is 109.5 degree, here the bond angle is 120, and here the bond angle is 180. And as you know, we already discussed this, the S character in SP3 is 25% only. The S character in SP2 is 33.3%. And the S character in sp hybridization is 50%, the highest one. And keep in mind that due to the difference of S character, the acidity, electronegativity, similarly bond strength of these three hybridized carbon will be different. So you have to be very careful about the S character. You have to know what is mean by S character and what is the consequences of S character. If it has highest S character, what will be the effect of S character? To answer this question, you have to know the position of s orbital. S orbital is closer to nucleus. S orbital is nearer to nucleus, and that's the reason that the electrons present in s orbital are more tightly held by the nucleus as compared to p orbital. This is the key sentence, that s orbital is closer to nucleus than p, and the electrons present in s orbital are more tightly held by the nucleus as compared to the electrons present in p orbitals. So if you understand this sentence, you can answer the following question, that what about the electronegativity difference, acidity, stability, bond strength, etc. We can also compare these three in terms of unhybridized orbital. It has 0, 1, 1p unhybridized orbital, 2p unhybridized orbital. Electronegativity of sp3 is least, while electronegativity of sp is highest. The reason is more s character, more electronegativity, because s orbital is closer to nucleus, holds electron more tightly, and thus it has more electronegativity. I have already explained this. And I also mentioned here, is s orbital closer to nucleus? Sorry, space is not given here. So s orbital closer to nucleus and holds electron more tight, hence electronegativity of sp is more than sp3. Now look at the acidity. Sp3 is least acidic, while sp is highest acidity, has highest acidity. Why? Now you cannot say that due to the S character. Here the best way to answer is, actually the conjugate base of sp is more stable. Later on we shall explain what is mean by conjugate acid, conjugate base. So for the time being, I think we have not studied this topic, acid and base, so it will be difficult for you, but you have to keep in mind that the difference of acidity, and then later on when we shall inshallah present the topic of acid and bases, so then you will learn inshallah what is the difference between acid base, a strong acid, weak base, how acid base strengths are determined. So now here the answer is, actually the conjugate base of sp is more stable, the sp carbanion is more stable due to highest s character. Carbanion, carbon with negative charge. When carbon is negative charge and s character is more, it means that electron will be tightly held and the negative charge will be stabilized. Next comparison is in bond strength. So the general rule is, the more s character on carbon, the stronger the bond. Thus an sp-sp3 bond is stronger than sp2-sp3 bond, which in turn is stronger than sp3 and sp3-sp3 bond. That is, the bond which is formed by the overlapping of sp-sp3, the bond which is formed by sp-sp3 overlapping, it will be stronger than the bond which is formed as a result of sp2-sp3 overlap. Similarly, the bond which is formed by overlapping of sp3-sp3 will be weaker. Why? Due to less S character. So the summary of this lecture is, you have to know what is hybridization, why we need to study hybridization, what is mean by tetravalency of carbon, how carbon get hybridized, what are different types of hybridization, what are different example of hybridized carbon, and how sp3, sp2 and sp can be compared, what are similarities and differences, what are similarities and differences among sp3, sp2 and sp orbitals. Here I have given an example of amoxicillin, a drug. Amoxicillin is, it has a complex structure. You can see benzene ring is there, amine group is also present, carbonyl carbon, ring system. You have to identify which atom is hybridized sp3, which atom is hybridized as sp2, and which atom is hybridized as this sp. So you have to identify, this is actually a homework, and you have to also to see that just like carbon, nitrogen is also hybridized, and nitrogen also show sp2 and sp3 hybridization. Later on, when you will study the amine and amide, then you will need to know about the hybridization state also. If nitrogen is attached with three atoms, it will be sp3 hybridized, and if nitrogen is attached to two atoms, it will be sp2 hybridized, and when nitrogen is attached to only one atom, it will be sp hybridization. I have one question here for you. Oxygen only show sp3 and sp2 hybridization. Why? Oxygen doesn't show sp hybridization. You have to find the answer. Now next is a very simple question for you. How will you determine the hybridization state of each atom? So you have to search, look, and find the answer for this one. And this is practical example for you. When you use your mind, inshallah, you will cover the topic, and then you will understand that which atom of a particular molecule is hybridized sp3 and which atom is hybridized as sp2. And when you know hybridization and also the nature of bond, you can also determine the geometry. So the next example is determine the geometry and hybridization. I have taken this question from the internet. And these are two typical examples. In next exam, inshallah, I shall include some questions. One question, I think, one short question, that what is the hybridization of each atom in the following molecule? Inshallah, you will be asked to answer a short question, and the question will be, what is the hybridization of each atom in the following molecules? I will give 2, 3, 4 molecules, and then I will ask you that what is the hybridization. So it doesn't mean that I will give this example. I will give any example, and if you know the topic, inshallah, it will be very easy for you to identify and to identify the geometry as well. So thank you very much. This was all about the hybridization. You have to answer the question, what is hybridization? The story behind hybridization. Why do we need to study hybridization? What is the purpose of hybridization? And how hybridization explains the tetravalency of carbon atom? Then what are different types of hybridization? And how will you compare sp3, sp2, and sp hybridization? Thank you. Assalamu alaikum.